Hey everybody, Glenn Hausman here for No Vacancy News, brought to you by SkyTouch, the industry's leading cloud-based PMS. I found Mr. Marco Roca, President, Global Development, and Chief Development Officer with Caesars Entertainment. Marco, congratulations. You just made a big announcement. The first non-gaming hotel, Caesars Republic, coming to Scottsdale. Pretty cool deal.
Thank you, Glenn. It's great seeing you as usual. Really enjoy these conferences and especially catching up with good friends. Thank you.
Thanks. All right, so I would love for you to tell me a little bit about Caesars Republic and why, pray tell, even bother going into the non-gaming world?
Well, that's a really good question. It all really was born from our 57 million loyalty guests who said, yeah, I've got all these points to burn and I'm coming to Vegas very often, but I'd like to have some optionality. So how can you take all of this really cool integrated resort idea and deliver it somewhere where there is no gaming, because I really love the experience, and I really love the sharing and all of this. And how can you deliver that to me without the gaming aspect? So that's where it was born.
Right. I also think strategically, you don't have to answer if you don't want. I think it's a smart move for gaming companies to go in that direction, as I think folks, younger folks in particular, start to move a little bit more away from the gaming aspect of it and spend their money in different ways while still on property.
Well, yeah, you see in millennials, they're not into gaming as much as baby boomers were. And so although that's always going to be our core business, really to be able to provide that experience and that those, you know, procured special moments, I think that's really important. And that's what the client is asking for.
So tell me a little bit about what Caesars Republic is as a brand.
So as a brand, it really tries to take the elements of Las Vegas, and it tries to be bold, and it tries to let you have a little fun and let your alter ego go a little crazy here. And so it's a lifestyle hotel. It's not a boutique hotel. It's lifestyle. And so we're leaving it very loose so that you can be localized. So the food will be localized. The environment, no two will be alike so that you can really fit in. Paris should not look like New Orleans, should not look like New York, should not look like San Antonio.
Right.
So Scottsdale, we're really, really excited about.
That's excellent. So I'm sure a guy like you who's been in this game for a long time, you probably have a bunch of deals in your pocket ready to go. Are you able to share anything now?
Well, our pipeline is pretty robust. We have about 114 deals, but that's across all of our brands. So Caesars Palace, Caesars, as you know, we just opened Dubai, a Caesars and a Caesars Palace. It's doing amazingly well. We're really excited about that. We've announced another one in Cabo as a Caesars Palace. But so across our Caesars, Caesars Palace, Flamingo, Link, and now Caesars Republic, we have 114 deals in the hopper. And so these are moving through letters of intent, about 21 of those out now.
Wow. Well, it's a big deal that's happening right now as the gaming industry kind of becomes more traditional hospitality, and traditional hospitality is becoming more like other industries as well. It's a fun time to be a part of it. You definitely are a happy guy. How's life over at Caesars?
Oh, it could not be better. We're just really exciting, and business is thriving, doing terrific, and we're really excited with all the directions that we're taking.
Excellent. So thanks for watching No Vacancy News. For Marco and myself, have a great day.